The following pages have been reproduced with the kind permission of the Royal Highland and Agricultural Society of Scotland and Mr. B. Kennedy, the author of this book.
The following pages from the book that I've been showing, 16 to 19, and there should be 1915, possibly 1916, because the next chapter is 1917. So that's another 4 pages for you to study.
Yeah.
We got all the bits and pieces put back together. Put the camel thump on, because if we get flow, I'm hoping it hits that plastic bag and goes down. Put it. I put the vacuum sensor back in as well. So a few shifts. Stuck hot. Or he is back, he is back today. Needs a bit of gas. Quite hard to just hit the heater. I'm just going to leave that running for a while and I'll bring you back when we plug the outlet in there, and that'll give us pressure. I'm going to let this run for a wee while. That's been running a wee happily with itself. Steady flow of oil coming through, so what we'll have to do now is take this camel sump off and plug the outlet side. This will be the outlet side and there's an outlet side. I made a nylon thing go in there before, but I'm not sure where it ended up. Maybe made it into something else, so that will be my next job, to take this off, plug the outlet, and see if we've got pressure. Hopefully we do. And hopefully it's better than the 300 we had before. I've been putting some of these shafts back and learning a few things. There's a screw here and it sits in this groove. But to get this in, you need to put it in upside down. Just put a wee bit of grease in. I've been just trying it. So you need to put it in that way, otherwise there's not enough room to get it in. And then line up the holes. You get it to where you need it to be. It's getting better. Just shot past him. And then you can flip it back around to where it's supposed to be. All we need to do is find out where that screw sits. Not too bad there. Just take it out and put some more grease on it. There's also a spring and a detent ball go down in there. I don't know where they are. So you need that bit down. And it goes into a wee pocket sometimes. There we go. Just that last wee bit. Screwdriver. Yeah. and you can bring it up to where it's supposed to be, which is there. Bring that stiff. And then the screw. This is a locking screw. Fits in the gap. Machine screws never good to get in. There we go. And I didn't lock it in place. Oh goody, why is it not going in this lock? It's locking now. Okay. That sits in a pocket, so I don't want to go anymore. I think this was seized up, or some of these mechanisms were seized, and that's why it broke the pin at the back. So our next trick is putting all the bits in. So that, that's where your detents go in there. I'll put them in a bit. So that goes in with the hole that way. And then this goes down. Oh, can't do it that way yet. We'll find the big bit we've lost. Pencil, I see it. No, it's catch 22 here. Which bit do you need to put in first? Right, that goes that way. That way. No. Must go the other way. No, I've got a picture in my pocket. I'll just take a quick look. Sticks at the front. Right, so this goes facing this away. But I think we'll have to loosen that screw so it'll come further to get it on. Which it will. So we put a grease on it just to help it. There'll be plenty of oil in here anyway. There we go. And I'll take that back to its position. Let's slide back and forth. Might have to make a new screw for there. Anyway, let's put the thing together and see what happens. Right, so now we'll have to... This is quite handy because we've got a screwdriver slot in the end of here for turning this to line up. So that side and that side. It goes to the far side if I remember right. Put that picture up in the video, so that would go to that side, and then it picks up these forks on this TCU thing. So we can move back and forth with. In there. So we need to line up the pin hole. Which is far too far in. I made a new screw for here. I made that noise a minute ago. Well, it took me more than a minute to make it, of course. Not seen the pinhole. It's a roll pin that's in here. Chop it. Almost have a boot. And a bolt. That. Then when you turn the TCU control thing up here, it moves that. Oh, it's lovely and free that now. It's just a little bit stiff, but not seized. Okay, we've still got to find a ball bearing and a spring to go in there. Otherwise it can move further than it should. That should be the maximum there. We'll measure that and see what size of ball bearing we need. It's not recording. Yep. A bit of an earthquake then. Six and a half, probably 6 mil, would you say? Not be imperial, so. See what it is. 256 thou. Just get a 6 mil bearing and wood in there. Here's some we bought earlier. Would you believe it? I've got 5.5 and then 6. And then 7. Don't think there's 7. No, 6 mil going down in there. So they're terrible for getting themselves mixed up with each other. These, when they first arrived from Hong Kong, I had great fun sorting them all out. Plastic in there just to help keep them in order. Now what we'll need is to find a spring that's suitable. Mm-hmm. I wonder what keeps that in. It's not going to keep it in, unless there's a screw goes in there. A thread. No thread either, because when you put that in, it's never missing unless the valve itself is it. Ah, I think it does. That pin, got a funny feeling that pin was in that hole. Moves it to the different positions for different things. There we go. Something right here. Oh, it won't do that. Of course it'll come forward with the lever. And then that hits the spool valve adjustment.
I think I haven't taken this to bits yet. Been thinking about it and not thinking about it. So what sets that? Musty. I mean, the spool valve's free. It's moving okay. So, don't really want to muck about it if I can help it. And then that would have to come forward. Yeah, that's pushing the spool valve in. So you'd be going down. It never went down because there's a broken lever goes on here, which we need to fix. You call that abutment plate. So TCU is over this side. Just I need to sit. Right, I'll put this back in. So good. Blue Peter fashion, one I made earlier. Unfortunately, the footage I had of taking this thing to part, the SD card I was using at the time had a bad spot on it and it kept recording onto there and then you couldn't see it. Seems tight. Everything moving. Probably come forward. Yes, when you push down on the quadrant thing, it pushes that back and then it pushes the smoke valve in. But it would never do that before, and I think that's because of the broken lever. That's moving nicely. Mind you, the indents now here. Balls there. Yeah, the ball's jumping up and down, so that's good. So we'll need to get a spring to go in here. Probably take this thing to bits when I'm feeling better. Not been great lately, so. Waiting on yet another hospital appointment. Not two, actually. Okay, some of the bits in that box. So if you're looking for that screw, it's under this gas, metal gasket thing. Which one fits one way? Yeah, there's that great long thing with the big spring goes in there, isn't there? So we'll need to get a circlip for there as well. Spring. Boom. Point 8 millimeters, we said about 6, 4. Right. I'm not sure. I didn't see a bearing come out of there when I took it apart. I mean, that's moving freely. As you can see. Probably the spool valve alone. Very tempted just to put everything back together again and see if it works or not. Do anything. Now that it's actually got some pressure. It was just shy of 2,000 this morning. PSI. It's a bit better than 300 that was getting. Not sure. What was there? There's just nothing to hold that in, which is confusing. Okay, that's all I'm doing today. Well, I finally figured out where the broken bit goes. I watched my videos back, and then I watched Barry's videos back, and I watched Shane's videos back, and couldn't think where it went. And then I watched another one in my, just the raw material. And I happened to say, oh, this bit's been interfered with. That goes on the end of there, welded to this. It was strange it only had one bolt attaching it. That'll sit like that, so I'm going to take that out and see if we can weld it back in its place. Oh, grey cells were working for a change. Another bit that's been broken on this tractor. I think somebody's been in here with a big hammer. I wonder if they couldn't fix it. Maybe it was just too expensive to fix. So, yep, I can see the broken bit. See, that's broken. Oh, that'll sit on it. That bit will sit onto it. Even matches it. Now the question is, how are we going to get it to line up? Probably going to be bad. What I might do, I'll take that out, give it a clean, and then we'll maybe just tack it and try it and see if it lines up. And what have you. So this bit here, with that bit broken, it would have been able to wander about. Probably the reason the thing didn't work, I think. This is a fun bit to get in. There we go. That's in here. There should be another plate. So with that being broken and able to do that, when the controls were moved, these may not have been in the right place for it to engage. And there you go. Even worse, somebody's built it up so it doesn't even match. What I'll have to do is clean this up and then put this back in without any of the other bits in. See if we can get it to line up. I must have built it up and ground it back. Okay, I'll get that cleaned up and I'll bring you back in a bit. Going to need to do a bit of grinding. They've built it up. Right, it seems to go that way. You can see there's been an angle grinder in there at some point. I don't know why that's rounded. And this has all been built up. I think it's, is that cast material? It's cast. Probably need to get some dissimilar rods. Try it with the MIG first, see how it goes. Well, like I say, I'll have to grind it away a bit. Oh, no, don't go that way. Goes that way. The round goes to there. As you can see, that probably should be there. I think what I've done is welded that up just so it can't turn. So I'm not going to clean all that off of there. Right, I'll just bring you back in 4 as I'm doing different things. See, I might have to get the summer rods. See. There's the other option, is just carry on with what they've done, build it up, dress it, bore a hole. If the welding doesn't work. This has certainly been a challenge, this tractor, shall we say. Challenging bit is finding out all the information you need. There's 2 different manuals and that they don't agree with each other all the time. Right, there's 2 different ones for the hydraulics as well. Anyway, I'll shut you off there and I'll go into the grinding and bring you back when I'm getting ready to work.